Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss how to test the construct validity using CFA outputs from AMOS. We have tested the construct reliability in the previous video. The next step is to test the construct validity. In DAV726, I have a video explaining the concept of construct validity and two types of validity, convergent validity and discriminant validity. In this video, we'll perform these validity tests using CFA outputs. There are several ways of testing construct validity. Byrne 2010 introduced the method so-called multi-thread multi-method. This is a popular method of testing construct validity, especially discriminant validity. However, this method requires multiple thread factors and method factors, which may not be available in all studies. Head on 2010, Chapter 13 introduced a more effective method using Average Variance Extract, or AVE. This method is easier to perform and provide more accurate evaluation of construct validity. In this video, we'll use this method. First, let's examine the convergent validity. Convergent validity refers to the extent to which measures of the same construct are correlated. In other words, it provides empirical evidence that items that are indicators of a specific construct should converge or share a high proportion of variance in common. Typically, we can use standardized factor loadings to evaluate the convergent validity. Factor loadings of 0.7 or higher indicate good convergent validity, and factor loadings of 0.5 or higher indicate acceptable convergent validity. The second method is to use AVE to evaluate the convergent validity. This is a formula for AVE. We have sum of square factor loadings divided by the number of items. We will use Excel to calculate AVE using CFA outputs. This is the CFA model that we have tested and confirmed. Let's look at the outputs. Select estimates. We will find standardized factor loadings. Right click and select copy. Then paste these values to Excel. These are factor loadings for three factors, F1, F2, and F3. By examining factor loadings, we can see that all factor loadings of F1 are greater than 0.5, indicating good conversion validity. However, for F2 and F3, we do notice some items with factor loadings less than 0.5. Let's calculate AVE for each factor. Per the formula, we need to get the sum of square factor loadings. First, we calculate square factor loadings. We add another column and call it square loadings. Equal sign, click on the loading value, which is cell D4, cap sign 2, this means square, and hit enter. Then we just need to copy down the function by moving the pointer to the lower right corner and drag it down. Now we have all square values of factor loadings. In next column, we calculate AVE for each construct. We will use average function, equal sign average parenthesis, highlight all square factor loadings for F1, which is E4 to E12, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F1 is 0.495. We do the same for F2. Equal sign, average, parenthesis, highlight all square loadings for F2, which is E13 to E17, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F2 is 0.38. Similarly, we calculate AVE for F3. Equal sign, average, parenthesis, highlight all square loadings for F3, which is E18 to E24, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F3 is 0.359. The rule of thumb is that AV values of 0.5 or higher indicate good convergent validity. We see that AV for F1 is 0.495, which is close to 0.5, so it is considered acceptable. However, AV values for both F2 and F3 are less than 0.5. This evaluation is consistent with what we have noticed from examining factor loadings. I would recommend reporting both factor loadings and AV values when we evaluate convergent validity. In this case, we can conclude that there is not sufficient evidence to confirm convergent validity for F2 and F3. Some changes might have to be made, such as removing the item with the lowest factor loading and run the CFA model again. The rule of thumb is to remove one item at a time. Nonetheless, note that CFA is a theory-driven method, so we need to review the theory and literature and examining each item carefully before deleting any item. And we have to make sure to have enough items for each factor, otherwise the model will be affected. The next step is to test discriminant validity. Discriminant validity refers to the extent to which constructs are distinct. That means discriminant validity provides empirical evidence that a construct is unique and captures some phenomena that other constructs do not. In this video, we'll test the discriminant validity by comparing maximum share variance, or MSV, with AVE for each construct. MSV is actually the square of intercorrelation between two constructs. If MSV less than AVE, we can confirm the discriminant validity. To do that, we need to extract the correlation coefficients among three factors from CFA outputs. We go back to AMOS output text and select estimates. We scroll down until we see correlation section. Right click and select copy. Then we paste the values to Excel. We will add another column called square correlation. Equal sign. Select the correlation value, which is cell 04, cap sign 2, and hit enter. This is the square correlation between F1 and F2. Then we drag this down to copy the formula. I will delete the correlations among error terms since we do not use them. Now we need to compare AVE for each factor with all square correlation or MSV of that factor with other factors. For example, F1 has AV of 0.495. Square correlation between F1 and F2 is 0.3, and between F1 and F3 is 0.126. Both of these are less than AVE. F2 has AV of 0.38, and square correlation between F2 and F1 is 0.3, and between F2 and F3 is 0.15. Both less than AVE. So far, so good. Finally, F3 has AVE of 0.359. Square correlation, or MSV, between F3 and F1 is 0.126, and between F3 and F2 is 0.15, both less than the AVE. Again, the expectation is that all MSVs, or square correlation values, of one factor with other factors must be less than the AVE of that factor. In this case, we achieve this expectation just confirming the discriminant validity. So that is how to test the convergent and discriminant validity using AMOS and Excel. Thank you, and bye now.